Look at Donald having a nap. He's so cute.
So Meg, we're in the weeding area now of Kilimanjaro. You see everybody lined up?
Well, the animals might eat a bit.
Jumbo, everyone! Welcome!
Okay, it's para nosotros.
On we go, Meg.
Slide all the way. They get their name from the pink color that appears on their backs during mating season. A group of pelicans is also collectively referred to as a mon.
Masai giraffes. We can identify the Masai giraffe by the leaf-like pattern on their coats with the jagged edges, as opposed to the smoother, more net-like pattern that we're used to seeing on giraffes. Giraffes also only sleep 30 minutes to 2 hours a day. And every individual giraffe does have its own unique coat, just like the giraffe. Coming up over here on our left, we meet these small trees. We've got some white-bearded wildebeest, also known as the blue wildebeest or common wildebeest. In Africa, that's the language of the Dutch settlers of South Africa, wildebeest means wild beast. And in Swahili, they're known as gnus, spelled G and U for the sound that they make. Wildebeests are part of one of the largest animal migrations in the entire world. Now here on our right, we've got a springbok. Full-grown springboks will stand about 30 feet. We're also the world's most colorful monkey. You can see by looking at the bright red of the markings on their faces and on the male's head. They're also very social. They'll spend several hours a day grooming each other. It's one of the most important parts of them. It's actually the females that do most of the hunting for the pride. The male might help take that large prey. Oh, and then up here ahead of us, soon to be on our right, I see a bontebok. Bontebocks can appear to look almost purple in bright sunlight due to an oily secretion of their coats. They were recently extinct in the wild, but now thanks to restoration of their habitats and reintroduction, they are making their comeback. We have three grand zebras, also known as the common zebra. Zebras have incredibly strong hind legs. They'll kick with enough force to break the jaw of an attacking lion or crocodile. When a zebra's born, it'll be able to walk within minutes, and within a few hours of birth, it will be running with the herd.
How did you like that?
That was great. It's always good. You know what? First of all, giraffes are number one. And zebras are very cool too, right? But I love the lion sitting on that huge, huge rock. That was phenomenal.
That was cool.
They sleep 20 hours a day.
Okay, so now we're gonna go get some lunch.
We're gonna eat and then we're gonna go see Festival of Lion Kings.
Let me eat my lunch. Dad's just gone to the washroom. And my veggies. And we're gonna go to the Festival of the Lion King.
So, yeah.
Let's see how long it takes him to come.
Best of the luck.
Which way do we go?
Actually, it's 5-5.
No, they went this way.
Oh, I see it. Hello, Robert. Are you excited for the show to start?
Always. It's a great show.
Still people bullying in. Who do you think, what side do you think we're going to be?
I have no idea.
I'm going for elephants. How about you?
Elephants.
Elephants?
Welcome. We have been expecting you. We are here today to welcome you, one and all, to the Festival of the Lion King.
Welcome to the world.
His friends throughout the land in this tribal celebration. Time for introductions. My name is Kume. I am the leader of this group. Kume is Swahili for masculine and strong. What do you think? And next we have Nakawa,
which is Swahili for good looking.
Hey, good looking.
And this is Kubibi, which means impatient.
Oh, it means princess.
And finally we have Swahili,
which is Swahili for the gift.
The gift.
The gift. And if you want to stay good looking, you best back off the attitude, mister. Besides, there's a gentleman right over here who thinks I'm the gift. Oh, yes. And what's your name?
Martin.
Martin. Well, I think that's Swahili for it's my lucky day.
Everyone, Sumi and the gang will be arriving here in a minute. And we want to make them feel welcome when they get here. So, we're going to need your help.
And since this is the animal kingdom, and we're surrounded by animals, and Simba and the gang are animals, we should greet them like
animals. So, to start our beastly pep rally, each of us will lead one of the four animal sections. Now, let's see. I'll take the elephants.
I'll take giraffes.
I'll take lions.
And I'll take the warthogs and lions, honey. I'm going to need your help, so you come with me. Oh, yes. We're going to take this warthog section. Alrighty, gang, listen up. Martin here will demonstrate the sound that we as fellow warthogs will make. All right. Martin, place your fingers by your face to be your tusks, just like this. Yes, perfect. And now make a warthog sound. Martin, do you need a tissue? You okay? All right, turn this way with me. Stay right here. Warthogs, get those tusks up. And on the count of three, let's hear what you...
We're from Texas. Yes, indeed. And Francis here is going to show us his best lion imitation. All right, pause up. Now let's hear it. Wow, ferocious. Good job, Francis. All right, stay right here. Stay right here. We're going to turn around and help the crowd now, okay? All right, you all get the idea. On a count of three, let's see some lions. One, two, three.
Let's go! Let's see the bird of the sea.
bottom of the evolutionary ladder, let's hear it for the Tumble Monkey!
Till you find a love.
Rafiki Planet Watch.
Rafiki's Planet Watch, where we will encounter ghosts, pigs, and warthogs in a family-friendly area. But there's Charlie.
Come on! I like this guy right here, right?
He looks a little bit hungry. Oh, everyone's sleeping!
His stomach is not going to happen. Oscar, come on this side. Look at you, can cut his face. There you go.
That's all I remember.
That's the easy one.
I know they did this every day.
Pretty much just a playground. Oh my god, look at the pig!
Come here. Oh, I went, no! I was like,
come here.
I haven't seen a spit in a while.
I know, but then I was like, spit.
I'm almost surprised.
Let's go inside.
So she has 500 different sounds that she makes that are parrot noises that they can communicate. But then whenever it comes to our language, think of it almost as being bilingual. Where there are some people that are bilingual and know a lot of different languages. There are some parrots too. But not all of us are great at learning a whole bunch of different languages. Keep trying that, Rosetta Stone. One day I'm going to get Spanish now. But with her, she actually does say a few things. One of the things that she says, one day I was underneath her cleaning, and she looked down at me and she said this. It's what you do. So,
hello.
Yeah, so they can learn anything they want to, but I did try to tell one of our parents, I was trying to get him to say save the rainforest, so I said it every single day for an entire year.
Oh, yes, he was like, don't take the rainforest.
Nope, he looked at me and went, hey, baby. I was like, really? So you have to watch everything you say around him, but also know that you can't make it.
Hello. Hero! And I believe we have a fast pass now, don't we?
The zoo.
Every time again.